Committee representative.
That would be me, and there was no meeting.
Thank you. Report from the Agriculture Advisory Committee representative.
No meeting.
Thank you. And do we have any comments, or do we want to make a motion on the minutes of January 4th, 2017? Looks like we have to do that one first because we had a...
I'll move adoption of the minutes as submitted.
Seconded.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
And then I do have one comment for the February 15th, 2017 minutes. There are a couple, my name is all over on the Prisabella, but one of them's right.
And it's your job to figure out which one's right.
Yeah, which one?
It's all phonetic. Yeah. Don't swear. Yeah.
It, so it doesn't matter too much, but that's my only comment. And does anyone have a motion on the minutes?
So moved.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay.
Gotta have a short list.
Yeah. So now we'll open this up to public comment. You may address the commission about anything that's not on the agenda. So anything that is not on the agenda, you're open to talk to. And you do not have to introduce yourself, but you're more than welcome to.
I'll go ahead and do it. I know they have an option. My name is Jerry Morrow, and Mr. Chairman, members of the commission, it seems like strange addressing you. I've sat up there for 14 years as a planning commissioner. And after 14 years, I thought we need this, a lot of new blood. But I'm here tonight representing the California County Planning Commission Association. I'm the past president, and I sit on the board of directors of the planning PPCC. And I'd like to go ahead and pass these out, and I know when I pass them out, you have to keep them, so. Especially, I'm here to address the new commissioners and the older commissioners. I see two of them here, Dick Plant and Jerry. And we had a lot of late nights and good times, didn't we, here? First of all, this is going to be the 87th annual conference of the California County Planning Commission Association. And as I said before, it's great training for the new commissioners and for all of you. I've talked to Mr. Gonzalez. And their budget is a little bit tight, but there's enough budgeting for any of the planning commissioners that would like to go to our it's in Visalia. And it's going to be on May 5th and 6th. And Friday, usually we have a Friday, that'll be our main day. And I don't know, how many of you here went last year to the commission?
Went the year before.
Okay, I see Charlotte went. But anyhow, we have Shelley Davis King is going to be one of our speakers, and if you are familiar with Shelley, she's going to speak on archaeology for Tulare County. She'll be one of our speakers on Friday. We have a full day. There's a full lunch that you'll be having, and then that night after we conduct our business, we'll have a little gala at one of the restaurants, and then you can walk around Visalia and see what's there. Also on Saturday, that's the big day that we do. We have a bus tour that we take, and that program on Saturday, we'll be going to Dry Creek Reservoir, and there'll be a gravel quarry that we'll visit, and then we'll visit a terminus dam and look at the spillway, and other than that, we'll go and have lunch at the old Buckaroo Historic Entry in the Mission District and the county. In the afternoon, we'll have a tour of a dairy and a gravel and pit that we'll go see. So there's a lot of activity that'll be on Friday and Saturday. When Mr. Gonzalez, I talked to him, they'll pay your registration and also your hotels. So anytime you want to register, if you decide to do that, you can see the secretary, Mr. Gonzalez, secretary. But at that rate, I thank you. And again, I think if you decide to go, you'll have a great time, and especially for new commissioners, I think that you'll enjoy it. Okay, well, thank you again. It's a pleasure being here.
Thank you. Any questions?
Yeah, is there any questions?
Doesn't look like.
Thank you
very much. Any more public comments?
I would just like to request, since I'm not the only one here tonight and we have a large audience, that you speak into your mic so everybody can hear you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Any more public comment? Seeing no more public comment, I will close public comment and move on to the agenda. And let's have staff present the first project.
table. In the meantime, I'll just do a quick introduction of myself. My name is Kimberly Mahoney. I'm the project planner for all three projects that I'll be presenting tonight. And we'll be starting with a rezone and conditional use permit application for Mr. Nathan Gorham. So here at the Community Resources Agency in the Planning Division, we try to incorporate the county's mission, vision, and values in all of the projects that we process and make sure that those projects in some way align with the mission and vision and values of the county. And so this presentation serves to demonstrate how Mr. Gorham's rezone and conditional use permit project does adhere to those. Okay, so what is the purpose of a zone change application and conditional use permit application? A property owner is required to apply for a zone change and have it approved if the property owner desires a land use that's not allowed under the existing zoning on the property. And a conditional use permit application is required. Each zoning district has two categories of uses, permitted and conditional, and if they want to be able to use one of those conditional uses, they must have a conditional use permit. The project description is an ordinance for zone change RZ17-001 to rezone a 0.9 acre portion of assessor's parcel number 9605029 from open space to residential estate 5 acre minimum and a 0.9 acre portion from RE5 to open space. So it's a direct swap of equal size portions of property. It's located at 17779 Route 5 Road in Sonora and its general plan designation is rural residential. Here's a project site map right here. Can everybody see this?
Yes.
I feel like I'm a huge block. Right here is the project site. Next. Okay, so I wanted to take a few minutes to go in depth into what these images show. It does show the existing zoning of Mr. Gorham's property right here. The dark outline is his property. The open space currently almost entirely surrounds his property, and the portion in the middle is the RE5. This right here is what Mr. Gorham is proposing to do with his rezone application. If you can see what the difference is removing this section of open space right here and another portion of the open space right here, and then transferring that all right here. Again, a direct swap, 0.9 acres for 0.9 acres. The purpose of this is it's a bit rare. He's in a kind of a rare situation where he has a water well on his property right here that's currently in the open space. He also has two building permits to build two single-family dwellings on his property, and he can't access his water well while it's in open space to be able to feed water to his houses. So he'd like to be able to remove this open space and move it instead to this area of his property. And in this area of his property, the topography of his land is a lot more conducive to have vegetative growth and a lot less conducive to have any sort of development. He also has an application for the conditional use permit, which allows for the construction of a fence line, which follows this red dashed line right here. If you can see, this blue line is an ephemeral drainage that was identified from a biological report that we had done on the project. One of the suggestions from the biologist was to condition the project to make sure that the fence was built 10 feet away from that drainage, and that's a condition that's been approved or agreed to by Mr. Gorham as well. So that's a condition of the project to build it 10 feet off that ephemeral drainage. From his adjoining property comments, we had one comment in favor of his projects and no comments opposed. And then, how does he meet the mission? How are we meeting the mission with Mr. Gorham's project? Certainly creating a healthy and safe community, because the interest of his vegetation removal within the open space area is for the purpose of wildfire prevention, to protect himself and his family on the property, and to construct a fence that surrounds his property to be able to promote safety on his property as well. Exercising natural, cultural, and financial resource stewardship. The project did identify some opportunities to mitigate some biological resources, and those are implemented into the project, and there's no identified cultural resources. promote economic prosperity. It expands the use of his property to its full extent by allowing conditional uses on his property, and it doesn't compromise the biological integrity of his parcel, so it will thereby increase the value of his property. And enhancing the quality of life, it allows for conditional uses of the parcel, which promotes a higher quality of life associated with benefits of property ownership. Our findings, and based on our recommendations at the Community Resources Agency, is that relative to the zone change application, the zone change is consistent with both the general plan and the ordinance code. The site is suited for the uses that are permitted within that zoning district that he'd like to rezone his property to, and it's categorically exempt from CEQA. As for the conditional use permit, it's also found to be consistent with the general plan and the ordinance code. It won't overburden existing municipal facilities, excuse me. The size and terrain of the project site are suitable for the use. The proposed development will not be substantially detrimental to the health or safety of those that reside on the property, and it's also categorically exempt from CEQA. Tonight, you have the ability to either approve the project with conditions, approve it with modifications, or deny the project in whole. Are there any questions?
Go ahead, Peter.
On, excuse me, per the fence, I notice it says deer friendly. Is that basically a height limitation so that deer can get over it? Is that generally what we're being told?
And materials, yes. But it is a height limitation that was identified in the biological report, and that's what we've implemented in the conditions for the project.
Okay, so it'd be like 4 feet or something.
I think it's larger than that. Deer can really jump.
Oh, but, no. My garden will attest to that. But,
right.
I just was trying to get a feeling for what you meant, so okay.
I can refer to the project file that we have to get you an exact, but I think that it's larger than 4 feet.
Other questions? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
So now we'll open this to public comment. First, we'll go with those who would like to speak in favor of the project, and then we'll go to those who would like to speak in opposition of the project, and then we will go to those who are neutral. So let's start with those who would like to speak in favor of the project. Come on up. And again, you don't have to introduce yourself, but you're more than welcome to.
That's okay. Nathan Gorham, I'm the applicant.
Please wait till you get to the stand.
My apologies, Nathan. Yep. Gorham, I'm the applicant. I just wanted to speak to the height that you were in question. It's to 60 inches of deer friendly. Any other questions?
No. Doesn't look like. Thank you. Are those? Oh.
Commissioners, Bob Osborne. I'm Mr. Gorham's adjoining neighbor to the west, and I'm in favor of his proposal. Thank you.
Are there any others that would like to speak in favor of the project? Seeing none, I'll close that to have any that would like to speak in opposition. Seeing none, I will close the public comment for that portion.
Huh? Gotta get neutral.
Oh, is there anyone that would like to speak in neutral? All right, now I'll close the public comment. So it comes back to the commissioners. Do we have any discussion or questions more?
I have no questions, Mr. Chairman, but the presentation was very well done, and I thank you for that.
Yes, thank you.
Mr. Chairman, I'll move approval of the zone change based on findings A, B, C, and D, and move the approval of the conditional use permit based on findings A, B, C, D, E, and F.
I'll second.
And I'll second.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Approved.
Does that automatically approve the conditions that they recommend?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. All right, so let's move on to the second item on the agenda. And we'll go again with a staff report.
Good evening again.
What? You again?
Get used to this face this evening. This project is for a general plan amendment and a site development permit for Mr. James Medeiros. Again, we like to try to be able to match with the county's vision and mission and values with every application that we process, and Mr. Medeiros' project is no exception. Okay. Okay, so what is the purpose served by a general plan amendment and a zone change application? A general plan amendment applies to any person that wants to apply for a change or amend any part of the general plan to be heard 2 times a year by the Board of Supervisors. And a site development permit is to ensure that certain types of proposed developments will serve to achieve a design which is desirable. A site development permit shall be secured prior to construction or expansion of any of the following to include building projects in a light industrial or M1 district. The project description is as follows. It's a resolution for General Plan Amendment 16007 to amend the general plan land use designation of 2.5-acre parcel from homestead residential and light industrial to just light industrial. The site development permit, SDP 16-006, is to allow the construction of 31,264 square feet of mini storage in 3 buildings ranging in size from 8,592 square feet to 11,472 square feet. It's located on 18678 Eagle Ridge Drive in Sonora, and the current general plan designation is light industrial and homestead residential. This right here is the project site. As you can see, it's a bit inconsistent, it's a bit odd. This section right here is the section that's zoned homestead residential, and this section right here is the section that's zoned light industrial. All of the properties on this side are all zoned light industrial, and all of these are zoned business park. So it's a largely industrial and commercialized area with one very small exception, and that's the homestead residential section of Mr. Medeiros' property. Because he would like to expand on his existing mini storage units on the adjacent parcel right here, he'd like to be able to bring this parcel into compliance with the general plan. I know this is extremely small and hard to read, but it just doesn't blow up well. So these 3 white rectangles represent the 3 buildings that are proposed to comprise that 31,000 square feet addition.
We don't have that one. We don't have that one. Okay.
I know this is even more difficult to read, but this is the landscape plan that was submitted by Mr. Medeiros. It shows lots of landscaping along this side of the building, which is the side of the building that fronts Tuolumne Road right here. So there's a very good amount of vegetation right here and landscaping proposed, as well as a wrought iron fence. So these are the signs. He has proposed a number of 3 signs in total, 2 of which will follow the same design to be placed on building that faces Tuolumne Road. As with any general plan amendment in the county, we consult with the Native American Heritage Commission to identify which Native American tribes we should be consulting with throughout the project to see if they have any comments. We consulted with the Chicken Ranch Rancheria of Miwok Indians and the Tuolumne Band of Miwok Indians, and neither tribe offered any comment. Adjoining property comments, there were 0 comments in favor of the project. There were 4 comments opposed that all had to do with parking on Eagle Ridge Drive, an anticipated lack of parking on the road for existing businesses that are there. How are we meeting the mission? This project meets the mission because it doesn't propose any development which would impact the integrity of the health or the safety of the community. It exercises natural and cultural and financial resource stewardship because it doesn't propose any development which requires CEQA review or mitigation. It's been conditioned to facilitate natural resource stewardship by adopting air quality measures. It promotes economic prosperity because the project supports opportunities for increased revenue of the property owner's existing business, and it enhances the quality of life by increasing available offsite storage for the community to enjoy quality of life associated with their own increased property space availability. Again, the county applies our own recommendations as findings of the project. The proposed development's consistent with both the general plan and the ordinance code. It's also consistent with the East Sonora design guidelines because it does fall within the East Sonora area of the county. It will not overburden the existing municipal facilities. The size and terrain are suitable for the proposed use. It will not be substantially detrimental to the health or safety of those on the property, and the potential impacts that are associated with the proposed project were addressed in the previously adopted mitigated negative declaration, and therefore no further CEQA review is necessary. Again, the findings for the zone change that apply, it's also consistent with the general plan and the ordinance code. The proposed development will not be substantially detrimental to the health or safety, and it is exempt from CEQA review. As always, you may either approve the project with the conditions that are before you, you may approve it with modifications, or deny the project altogether. Are there any questions?
On the two maps that we don't have that in our packet, do they have that in the public packet? There's two, if you go back to the maps. Yeah, those two.
Those are simply for these presentations.
Okay, thank you.
They detail the landscaping, although it's difficult to read, but if anybody requests that information, we can make that happen.
Okay. Any other questions?
Go ahead.
On the parking.
Right.
That would end up being addressed to the time that you actually did building permits for this. Is that correct?
The parking has been addressed in the agenda report as it's been written already. In accordance with the ordinance code, only one parking space is required for this type of construction, and that's already been implemented. In addition to the one parking space for the one employee that is employed by Jim Medeiros at this property, the air quality measures require that one low emissions vehicle parking space be implemented, and those are also included in his plans.
And the logic behind that is because this people coming to use this facility would end up driving to their storage unit and therefore not need a parking spot. Why do the customers not need a place to park, I guess, is my question.
That might be a better question for my boss.
So, I mean, we have parking standards for the county,
right?
And it's no different than any other jurisdiction. These types of uses require very, very few customer parkings. Generally, they're at the office when they're first getting keys, access, and that type of thing. There's keypads, and the parking is within the facility. If you look at the plan, I'll go back here. Where is it? If you look at all the areas in blue, those are all areas that the customers actually can park. And generally what happens, you do drive your site, unload your stuff, and then move on. And so what we find is there's very, very few problems with these types of facilities, and we don't want to overpark them.
Right. Okay. Thank you.
I also noticed it said there were four existing parking spaces. Did I read that correctly?
That's correct. The parking for this site will be shared with the existing mini storage facility that's on the adjacent parcel.
So that's on the existing one, already has four. That's what you're
correct. Okay. Yeah, that's correct.
That I didn't quite understand.
That's correct. So there's substantial, even more than required parking spaces. In this particular instance, the parking in accordance with the ordinance code is based off of a ratio of the number of employees that work at the business. And so since only one employee will remain at this location, then there's no need to increase the parking any further. However, we have asked that one of the parking spaces be converted to a low emissions just based on the air quality findings on such a large construction.
Most of the comments were based, though, on their activity as a flea market. Does that not change or change their business operation since it's a storage unit and then the flea market happens?
The flea market is an existing operation that's happening at an adjacent parcel at the existing mini storage. So it's not been proposed as a business that will take place at this parcel, specific to this application. There just have been comments that have been, I guess, brought to my attention from neighboring business owners with concerns with regards to the existing flea market business that operates in the amount of parking that it takes away from Eagle Ridge Drive for them.
Any other questions? Go ahead.
Well, to continue that, even if they continue the flea market, it wouldn't be substantially different than it is today. Right? I mean, unless they expanded it onto this property.
Correct. Correct. Which has not been proposed.
Okay. Right. Okay.
Any other questions?
Wasn't there a condition, or could there have been a condition that the people who were complaining about the flea market wanted to clearly delineate it so that all the parking would stay off of their parking, off of their area? Was that one of your conditions that you put in here?
The The parking that's referenced is largely referred to parking alongside the road on Eagle Ridge Drive. So I don't know that that's necessarily something that belongs to any other of the neighboring businesses. It just creates congestion. There's been concerns brought up with regard to the amount of space that's taken up on the side of Eagle Ridge Drive with all of those parked cars, with regard to even emergency vehicle arrival on site. But I don't know that it's any part of that road is anything that's owned by any other private organization on the road.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
So now we'll open it up to public comment. We'll start with those in favor, and then those opposed, and those neutral. So we will start with...
Can you put that landscaping back up for a second, please?
Those in favor.
First of all, my name is James Medeiros. I'm the owner of Goldmine Storage. And we've been in business for, I don't know, almost 10 years. First of all, I do want to thank the planning department, and especially Kim, for all the work she's done on this project and getting this rushed and to you on time. Now, just a month ago, this was all converted to 100 parking spots. So I don't know what all this is about. I know the other people in business, all right? Right now, I don't have a flea market, okay? I plan to submit another site plan for this flea market once I start construction. For this simple reason, I didn't want it to be held up, okay? But you guys already approved 100 spots right next door, okay? We're just waiting for our grading permits. It'll be done before the construction of the other, okay? So we're gonna have 100 parking spots. The county only asked us to have 40. Okay, so this is going to more and take care of everybody's problems. We also plan to put up signs on both the sides of Eagle Ridge, right here, tow away, and we're going to paint them red. And me and my neighbors, trust me, when I submit the flea market, they will not complain one bit, because I've addressed all their problems. Okay, it's just really an extension of the business I already have, and we're at 100% both complexes. So there's nowhere else to move but right next door. Now, she rezoned this. This property was originally zoned light industrial. She rezoned it because she was going to build a homeless shelter, the Mitchells. And their project fell apart. They decided to do something else because developing the property entailed a lot of stuff for them. And they're getting old, and they didn't want to deal with it no more. So they sold it to me, so I figured, you know, the best use would be what we're already using it for. And since there's metal buildings everywhere, you know, it fits in just perfect. So are there any other questions about any part of it? The landscaping, fences, everything is pretty well detailed in the plans. But that's it.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
I have a question. Mr. Madera.
Oh, okay.
Got
sure.
A peripheral vision.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm very pleased to know about the additional parking that yes, you sir. Just pointed out. And I think the entire commission is pleased to know that problem is going to be remediated. I think my concern is that the neighbors may not know.
Well, they didn't, because I just talked to them today. And
thank
they
you
go,
very
Jim,
much. Thank you.
Why didn't you tell us you were putting 100 spots in there? Yeah. I go, well,
that's important.
They wrote you a letter like 3 months ago. In January it was passed. I mean, I don't know what to tell people. I was pretty shocked when I seen those letters. But I know once I talk to them, you know, that, you know, we're all
thank you.
In a business park, you know, businesses help other businesses. And, you know, they clearly want the flea market, but they don't want it to impede on their customers. So that's why we decided to paint the curbs, put up tollway signs, and I told them from now on, you can just call and have them towed away, you know, because no matter how much you tell people, they're still going to park where there's the shortest walk. You know, that's just the way people are. But besides that, the flea market's been going well for 9.5 years, and, you know, we have a lot of people in the community that do support their incomes with, you know, selling at the flea market, and it's free entertainment for the community, you know, as long as that, you know. So we get a lot of people that never buy, but there are every flea market. But anyway, now it's under control. As soon as we can get it graded, as soon as the rain can stop, We hope within the next couple weeks we'll have the parking lot expanded. And like I say, we went through the planning commission in January or December. I don't know.
Okay. I do have a question. Yeah. I think it might be best suited for David. Okay. Is Eagle Ridge Road a county-owned road? Is it a? I think it's on.
Part of it.
Was exactly my question.
Yes, it is.
Is Eagle Ridge Road a county road?
Yeah, I was just going to comment on that, Commissioner. So the public road, you can't paint that.
Okay, well.
We'll handle that. So I was going to tell you privately. Well, but now that you brought it up, Commissioner, I'm sure.
Somebody's going to have to do something or the people will never stop. So, you know, I mean, as far as we got to put up some signs or something, you know, because even though there's parking right there, they won't do it.
David needs to finish.
So what I'm going to suggest is you come and talk with Duke York and myself, and we'll work through that issue together.
Okay.
And that the county has those kind of things and restrictions. We'll look at it and assess it and make those things. So
that's
the parking
fine.
Lot will help the issue, and we will make sure that that happens.
Well, yeah, because both roads, maybe 20 cars, 30 cars at the most. So 100 cars is going to, 100 spaces is going to be more than enough. You know.
Any other questions? Cool. Thank you.
Thank you for your time. I appreciate it. No, have a nice day.
Are there any others that would like to speak in favor of the project? Seeing none, we'll move on to those who would like to speak in opposition of the project. Seeing none again, we'll go to now anyone who'd like to speak neutrally about the project.
I was beginning to wonder if I was the only one who remembered this project, because I remember about the landscaping and the road. So it was the parking lot, and I remember when you were here about this. And I think your only neighbor is the Dambackers Green Waste, is that correct?
Yeah.
And he had to come here 3 times because it was going to smell so bad. But every time I've been there, it smelled quite heavenly, I thought. It was really nice. So my only question, so I see people parking on the road. So my only question is, does he get a backup of cars that would back up onto the access road, or is he pretty much just one at a time from what you see?
No.
I think the question would be for us, but then we'll probably defer to David. The question's asked over.
Right.
So David, do you want to address the commission
but
on that?
But I figure
that?
You don't know.
Okay.
So the backup that you're referring to,
mm-hmm.
They're on public roads, and we have to address that.
Okay, thanks.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Are there any others that would like to speak neutrally about this project? Seeing none, we will now close public comments. We'll bring it back to the commissioners. Do we have any questions for staff? Yes?
Just a comment. I think this is a really good general plan amendment. We're so short of industrial zone or an industrial general plan property in this county, just a handful, for us to put this back into industrial where it started from. That's good planning.
Just a Go ahead. Question comment there. Did I understand? I think I learned something. We do that twice a year, the opportunity to make general plan amendments?
Yeah, the counties are restricted to do that a couple times. We reserve one for the county and the others for the public. So it's in the spring and the fall, we usually do that.
Okay.
Any other questions? Would someone like to make a motion?
Are you ready for the motion?
Sure.
I move that we approve the general plan amendment GPA 16-007 based on findings A through G. May I also move that we approve the site development permit SRP 16-006 based on findings A through D.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
So moved. So we will now move on to our final project on the agenda. And one note, congratulations on 100% fully open. It's a good problem to have.
Yeah, right.
My boss suggests that I try my next presentation from a different position. So I'll
be in your head, maybe.
I was sitting for this last presentation. This is for General Plan Amendment GPA 16-006 and Zone Change RZ 16-009. Again, here's listed the vision and mission and values of Tuolumne County, which we try to incorporate in all of the projects that we process. A general plan amendment is, again, any person may apply to a change or amend any part of the general plan, which is heard twice each year by the Board of Supervisors. And again, a zone change, a property owner must have a zone change approved if the property owner desires a land use that is not allowed under the existing zoning on the property. Project description for GPA 16-006 and RZ 16-009 is as follows. A resolution for General Plan Amendment 16-006 to amend the General Plan Land Use Designation of Assessor's Parcel Number 3502008 from Open Space to Large Lot Residential and APN 3502015 from Open Space and Parks and Recreation to Large Lot Residential. An ordinance for zone change RZ16-009 to two parcels under Title 17 of the ordinance code as follows. So on 3502015, it's a 23-acre parcel. It's zoned open space with an airport combining district, and it's zoned recreationally with an airport combining district. The proposed zoning is to retain the airport combining district but switch it to a 20 zoning, all 23 acres. Assessor's parcel number 3502008 is a 14-acre property. It's zoned open space with and without an airport combining district, and they'd like to retain the same size portions of airport combining district, but to rezone the parcel again to A20, which is a general agricultural 20-acre minimum. It's located at 21285 Old Sonora Columbia Road in Columbia, California. And the general plan designation is open space and parks and recreation. Here's a project site of GPA 16006 and RZ 16009. This is the small section right here that's zoned recreationally. And then this is the portion that is zoned open space. This does a very good job of showing where the open space or where the airport combining district lies. This small section of this parcel is not within the airport combining district. However, the rest of the two parcels are within the airport combining district. And this shows right here the proposed A20 zoning to retain the airport combining district where it applies currently on the project site. And it also shows that you can tell by the dark brown color, the proposed zoning is consistent with other zoning around it. The Airport Land Use Commission was advised and sought out on this project because the project is within compatibility, Zone D of the Columbia Airport. The ALUC considered the project for hazards of flight, but ultimately found that there were none and that it's consistent with the compatibility plan on January 5th, 2017. Again, we sought out advisement from three tribes based off of a recommendation from the Native American Heritage Commission, the Chicken Ranch Rancheria of Miwok, the Tuolumne Band of Miwok, and the Washi Tribe of Nevada and California. Again, no tribes offered any comments on the project. There were two comments that were received by our office in favor of the project and no comments opposed. How are we meeting the mission? The project does not propose any development which would impact the integrity of the health or safety of the community. We are exercising natural, cultural, and financial resource stewardship because the project does not propose any development which requires review from CEQA and does not have any known cultural resources. Promoting economic prosperity, the proposed zone change allows for the expanse of the property owner's use of the parcel, which promotes opportunities for economic prosperity. And enhancing the quality of life, it does not increase the residential density of the project site, which allows the area to pursue the quality of life associated with a low-density residential area. Our recommendations in our report, again, double as our findings for the project. The findings of the general plan amendment is that it's consistent with the general plan. The site is suited to the uses permitted. It's in the public interest to amend the county general plan to allow future use of project sites, which are consistent with the policies and programs of the general plan and the land use patterns of the surrounding area. And the general plan amendment is exempt from CEQA. The findings of the zone change application is that the zone change is consistent with the ordinance code and the general plan, that it's suited for the uses permitted under the proposed zoning districts, and that it is, again, exempt from CEQA. As always, you may either approve the project with conditions, approve it with modifications, or deny the project altogether. Do you have any questions?
Go ahead.
If I understand properly, we have an open space designation now, and once this is done, we won't.
Correct.
Was there a reason the open space was put there in the first place that we know of? I mean, I in all my time working for the county and then now being on the commission, this might be the first time I remember we're not going the other way, where we're adding open space. So it seems a little unusual.
Correct. I agree. That's addressed. If I can just have one moment to address my report.
I just want to make sure I understand.
Oh, we're understanding it correct, that they are removing the open space and not implementing any more.
I was trying to find it in here, and
it's in there.
Yeah, I know I read it. I just can't find it.
I know now I'm on the spot, and I can't find it. It's my report. Here we go. Oh, okay, that's what this was. The open space zoning was automatically adjusted on this project site. The zoning previously in 1972, approved by Ordinance 701, was K zoning. And at one point, that entire zoning district was removed and was replaced entirely by open space. So the open space was not placed on this project site for any sort of protection of natural resources, but was instead just a kind of a blanket solution to getting rid of the K zoning.
I recall that. Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Question. It was recreational?
Yeah.
Currently, it's recreational.
Back when it was K, that was a name for recreational.
Well, we do have a K zoning currently that is recreational, but whatever it was in the 1970s, I'm not familiar.
One would have to have been born.
Okay, she wasn't even born yet, so we'll just leave it at that.
I think my mom was in high school then.
She's not the youngest one in the room.
Any other questions for staff? All right, so we'll bring it to public comment. We'll go for those who want to speak in favor, opposition, and then neutral. So we'll start with those in favor.
You again.
Should I sit over there, too?
Somebody who was born in 1972, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. I was in high school. Nice to see most of you again. It's been a while and some new faces. My name is Bob Osborne, and I represent the American Western Diocese in their endeavor to amend the general plan and change the zoning. How we got here tonight is an incredible story. It would take a long time. It is pretty neat. However, the proposal is for the property to be used as a monastery in some of the traditional senses, vineyards, orchards and gardens and so forth. And I can't think of a better neighbor to have than what is being proposed here. So with that, I respectfully request support from the planning commissioners so that we may move on to the board with your full support. And if you have questions for me, I'd be happy to answer them. Oh, and by the way, I'd like to introduce Father Ignatius. He's the principal player at the monastery.
Go ahead, Dick.
When you use the word monastery, what comes to mind of some of these 1,400 monks and so on, big concrete rock structures or whatever, you know what I mean. What are the plans when you use the word monastery?
Well, the so we're in way past the 1400s, and
I hope so.
There's modern houses that you can use and live in and support the monastery, and that's what's proposed. In fact, there is a single family residence there that is now being used in that manner. So it won't really look much different.
Is it being used as a monastery now?
No, it's being used as a single family
residence. Just a family home.
Yeah.
Are there any other structures envisioned, or just repurposing that particular structure and using it?
There are some in the future that will go through the building permit process. I think a second residence will be allowed on this, and I think that is proposed in the future.
Okay.
That will go through the building permit
process. We don't really concern ourselves with that yet, right?
Right.
David? Yeah.
That's correct.
Well, why are we using the word monastery when there is no monastery and apparently no plans to build a monastery?
I'm not sure I can actually answer that one for you, Mr. Plan.
Okay.
When I sat down with Father Ignatius and the support team that he has, that has been the nomenclature that we used for the application and so forth. I think a more detailed explanation, if you need it, would probably be provided by somebody else.
Well, certainly that doesn't really affect what's before us tonight. Right. Tonight is just strictly a zoning issue, not a building issue or whatever.
And initially, I kind of misunderstood what was proposed as a, you know, more like a public church, but that is not the case.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Although I think a 14th century takes a couple hundred years.
I will happily issue a building permit as long as I get to inspect it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, Commissioners. My name is Janice, J-A-N-I-S, Elliott. I actually am the former County Council of Calaveras County, and I was also the Assistant County Council for almost 20 years, and I was the primary land use attorney during all of those 20 years, and I'm not here as an attorney of record because I'm retired. But I am a friend of the monastery, and as I got to know Father Ignatius, there were some discussions about my husband, who's we call him Master Gardener, even though he won't accept that title, building some raised beds and gardening. And as a land use attorney through and through, my first question always is, so what are you designating in the general plan, and what's your zone? And nobody knew. So I went to the county website, and I did some searching, and I was like, oh, they're O. and K, which made absolutely no sense to me based on the surrounding land uses. So I met with Father Ignatius, and we were lucky enough to find Bob, and we sat down and we looked at the zoning code and the general plan, and we came up with a proposal that addressed the current on-site uses, most of the current proposed future uses, and also was the lowest impact use we could find that went well with the adjoining uses. So I did have a brief counter discussion with Bev Shane before she left, and I said, how did this get O and REC? It made absolutely no sense to me. And lucky enough, she remembered that actually a prior property owner was proposing a park in this area. So that explained partly why this is so completely different from all the adjoining uses. So we sat down and we picked A20. Currently, what's on site, there is a single family residential a house there that is partially used as a sanctuary where there is worship taking place. There are only two monks on site at this time. There is another building that will probably become the chapel. It is a much better suited one, and then the monks can live in the residence. So you don't define monastery in your zoning code, which is completely usual. Your zoning code pretty much mirrors what we have in Calaveras County. You do have church. It's a pretty broad definition. It didn't really address what's happening on site, but that's what we went with, and in A20, churches are a permitted use. Also, gardening. Potential on-site selling of vegetables. We're talking way down the road, though. We just have built two raised beds and are just starting to grow things. It's also, on occasion, there's a visitor to come worship with the monks, not very often, and occasionally an overnight visitor. And as I discussed with Bev, those are all incidental uses to the on-site primary use, which is for the monks to live there and worship, and hopefully bring a few more monks on board, because it's a big parcel that has a lot of issues. There's a lot of vegetation. It needs a lot of work. So if you have any questions, you know, I appreciate all the work the staff has done, and I highly hope that you recommend approval of the GPA and ZA to the board.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah. Go ahead. I wonder if you have a maximum number of monks on the property in mind.
Well, at this rate, it's very difficult, you know, to find people who want to live that type of ascetic lifestyle. Both the, as you can see, Father Ignatius is, as he calls himself, not a spring chicken anymore. There are occasionally young men who come to look and stay and practice, but so far nobody has actually accepted that particular lifestyle. So we don't have, you know, a maximum number. It's just, it's small. It's going to stay small, and I suspect it will always be fairly small. So, and the on-site residential use is very small, so that's also a limiting factor.
Thank you.
Okay.
Any more questions?
Any other questions?
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Any more that would like to speak in favor?
Good evening, commissioners. My name is Chris Barsanti, and I'm an adjoining property owner. I can confirm the previous woman's comment about the neighbor. I've been on my property for 38 years, and there was a proposed park at one time by the two owners before the Western Diocese. So I think that's where that all started from. I would just, you know, confirm that. My parcels are zoned A20, and they are general plan have the general plan designation large lot residential. So it's, you know, very fitting that this property would become that. And as you can tell from the map, there's BLM land all around it. And just in the front side are the RE5s, which, you know, is also, they're not fully developed. They have the, they have that zoning, but they're not developed. There's only one or two houses on them. So I just wanted to offer my support, and I think it'd be very fitting to get this into a general plan designation and zoning that is appropriate for the land. Thank you.
Thank you. Any more that would like to speak in favor?
Hi, I'm Janice Nelson from Columbia, and I'd just like to ask you to vote in favor of this amendment. I think it would be an asset to the community of Columbia and to our county. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm also in support, and one of the things I miss about Bob Steele being the District 5 representative and Jerry Morrow being the District 3 representative is that they always went to visit the properties of the applicants. And so Father Ignatius told me that none of you had been out to visit the property. And that's very disappointing. You also have a typo on here. But anyway, it's a very beautiful piece of property. And it was also consecrated as a monastery, I think back in 2015. So once in their religion it's been consecrated as a monastery, it can't really be used for anything else. So this kind of cleans up the ordinance to preserve this as God's holy land. So if you please don't disapprove this, because no, you don't know what might happen to you. So thank you.
The lightning.
With that, doesn't look like we have any more in favor, so we will now open it to those who would like to speak in opposition.
Really?
Anyone that? Brave enough now? Okay, with that, no one's brave enough. We'll go to neutral. Looks like we have one neutral coming.
That's a little rocky, neutral. Yeah. I'm not sure.
My name's Laquita Miner, and I am on the church board of Sonora Christian Life Center, which is across the street and up on a little rise from where this property will be, this monastery. And we would like to welcome them to the neighborhood.
Thank you.
Nice.
Any more that would like to speak neutrally? Okay, with that, we will close the public comment and bring it back to the commissioners. Any questions for staff or discussion? Okay.
I made a comment, and that is that, you know, we deal with this open space thing on and on, right? And in many cases, our open space rules actually end up having a negative impact. The impact on the land, you know, having someone who takes care of the land is a good thing for the spirit of open space, but our open space regulations makes it illegal to do anything to take care of the land. And so I'm in favor oftentimes if we can find a way to get the spirit of open space done by changing the zoning away from open space, I think that's a good thing.
Thank you. Any other comments? Was there someone who would like to make a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve the amendment to the general plan, GPA 16-006, A through D, and the zone change, RZ 16-009, A through D, as presented.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion approved. With that, we will close the meeting of April 5th, 2017. Thank you for coming.